I'm Teacher Lizelle, and I'm just so excited that you joined us today here at Father's Art Kidz. Now, for those of you who don't know, this is the first lesson in our brand new series called The Bible in 1 Year. And I must say, I'm really so excited for this series, but I'll tell you guys more about it a bit later in our lesson. So what we're going to do now is we're going to open today's lesson with prayer, and then we're going to sing some songs to God. So quickly close your eyes so I can pray for us. Lord Jesus, we just want to thank you for this wonderful day that you created for us. We pray that we would just have an amazing time here today at Father's Heart Kidz. Please lead and guide us as we go through today's lesson and help us to truly learn something new from your word. And Lord, as we praise and worship you with some songs, may we truly just forget about everything and everyone around us and be focused on you. In Jesus' name we pray this, and we all say, Amen. So guys, for the praise and worship, if you can, I want you guys now to get on your feet and follow along with the moves on the screen. So let's not wait any longer, and let's all sing and dance with all that we've got for God.
Jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. Jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. Jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. 'Cause jumping says I love you. Jump, jump, jump. Jump, jump, jump. Jumping says I love you. Jump, jump, jump. Jump, jump, jump. Jumping says I love you. I'm gonna strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the valleys are His, the stars are His handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Wow, wasn't that just so amazing to sing and dance for God and have a wonderful time in His presence? So what we're going to do now is we're going to start with our lesson of today. Now, like I said earlier, today is our first lesson in our brand new series called The Bible in 1 Year. Now, the whole point of this series is to work through the entire Bible in just 1 year. Now, I know that might sound impossible, but it's possible, guys. You see, the Bible we're going to be working from is called the Bible Storybook, and it has 42 amazing Bible stories in it that cover the basic stories from the beginning of creation to the end when Jesus now returns. So, guys, by the end of this year, we will now have worked through this entire children's Bible together. Now, for today's lesson, we're going to look at a story called In the Beginning, and it's based on Genesis chapter 1 to Genesis chapter 2 verse 4. Now, I'm sure most of you guys have heard of this Bible story before, but trust me, we're going to learn some amazing things from this Bible story, even if it's a story we've heard now before. So, let's quickly see what today's story is all about.
We live in a beautiful world. Just look at the amazing things around you. Let's go back to the beginning and see what the Bible tells us about how it all began. In the beginning, God made the heavens and the earth. God moved over the darkness and said, "Light!" He called the light day, and He called the darkness night. Day one, done! Then, God made a space to separate the waters above from the waters below. He called the space sky. Day two, done. God gathered the waters together and dry ground appeared. He called the ground land and the waters seas. Then He made plants like grass, grain, and trees. Day three, done. Then God made lights in the sky. He made the sun for the day, the moon for the night, and all the stars. Day four, done. God made fish to swim in the waters and birds to fly in the sky. "Have babies," He told them. "Fill the world with splashing and singing." Day five, done. Next, God made animals. He made farm animals, wild animals, and animals that crawl on the ground. "Just one more thing to make," God said. "The most special thing of all." So, in His image, God made man and woman. "Have babies," He said. "Take charge of the world. Care for the fish, the birds, and the animals." Day six, done. Then God looked at everything He had made. "It's very good," He said. So on the seventh day, He rested and made that day special. Day seven, done.
Ever wondered how God created this beautiful world we live in? I know I most certainly have wondered about this. Now, one thing's for sure, God didn't use glue to put the earth together. And I also didn't see anything in our Bible story that said God used tools like a hammer to create the earth. So, how did God do it? Well, guys, God is, you know, God. So that's how He did it. You see, God is not like us. He doesn't need glue and tools to make things. He is all powerful and He can do anything. So God simply spoke and the whole world came to being. Yep, everything God created was through Him simply speaking it into existence. Isn't that just so cool? I mean, think about it. How amazing would it be if you now were hungry and you could just say, let there be a sandwich, and then poof, out of nowhere, a sandwich appears. That would be pretty amazing, right? But let's just be honest. Most of us wouldn't speak a sandwich into existence. We would speak lots of chocolates and sweets into existence. And that's probably one of the many reasons we don't have that kind of power. Now, in today's story, we saw that God created the whole world and everything in it in just 6 days. Now, 6 days is not a lot of days. I mean, I can barely some weeks get to everything that's on my weekly to-do list. But for God, creating the whole world in just 6 days was a piece of cake, because nothing is impossible for him to do. Now, I quickly want to talk about something that God created on day number 6. It was the most special thing of all the things he created. Can you guys now remember what that was? That's right, God made humans. Now, can you guys tell me why this part of God's creation was so special? That's right, it's because we are made in God's image. You see, none of the other things or creatures God created were made in his image. We are the only ones that were made in God's image. And that's why we are so special to God. Now, I must say, it's just so awesome to think that God would choose us to be made in his image. Not a lion or a bird or a whale. He chose us, which truly shows us we are very special to God and that he loves us so much. Now, I don't know if any of you have maybe ever felt that you're not special good enough. Or maybe there's some of you who have been told that by someone else. Well, if you've ever felt like that, I want you now to remember today's Bible story and that you are made in God's image. And because you are made in God's image, you are very special and more than good enough. Now, God said something very important after he created humans. He said, take charge of the world. Care for the fish, the birds, and the animals. Now, this, guys, is one of God's very first instructions to us as humans. Call it now a special job God gave us. You see, because we are special to God, he entrusted everything he created on earth to us. So, guys, I want you to think of everything you have and know that whatever you have comes from God and he wants you to take good care of it. Now, guys, each week I want us now to learn and memorize a Bible verse from our story. And this week's memory verse is in Genesis 1 verse 31. Let's quickly read it together. It says, then God looked over all he had made, and he saw that it was very good. Wow, I just love this Bible verse so much, because it's so true. Everything God made truly is so good. Now, guys, to help us memorize this Bible verse, I want to add some moves to it. Let me quickly show you guys what I mean. Then God looked over all he had made and he saw it was very good. Genesis 1 verse 31. Okay, now guys, this time do it with me. Then God looked over all he had made and he saw it was very good. Genesis 1 verse 31. Well done, guys. Now, I want you guys to practice this memory verse this week, so by next week, you will have it memorized. Now, guys, not only do we actually have to memorize this Bible verse, but we also need to remember our Bible story of today and everything we learned from it. So to help us do just that, we're going to make a very cool craft. So let me quickly show you guys what craft we will be making. So guys, I hope you guys now enjoyed watching me showing you guys how to make our craft of today. I'm super excited to see now how your crafts are going to turn out. So please participate and download the pages you need to make this craft. All you have to do now is go to the description of today's video and click on the blue link where it says, here is today's craft link. Now, once you're done with your crafts, please send me a photo of how your craft turned out. Now, you guys can do that by either sending it to me over WhatsApp or by posting your photo now in the comment section of our craft post on our Facebook page. Now, guys, what we're going to do now is we're going to get on our feet again and sing one more song together for God before we now end off our lesson. So let's enjoy this next song together.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord.
Unfortunately, we are at the end of our lesson, but let's quickly pray together before we go. Thank you, Lord, that you love us so much and made us in your image. God, I just pray that if any one of us ever feels like we are not special or good enough, that you would please remind us of today's Bible story, that we are made in your image and that makes us very special and dear to you. Please help us to remember today's Bible story and everything we learned from it. And Lord, as we practice our memory verse of this week, please help us to memorize it. In Jesus' name we pray this, and we all say, Amen. So guys, that's our lesson for today. I hope you guys had lots of fun. And I can't wait now to see you guys again next week for lesson 2 in our Bible in 1 year series. But until then, have a wonderful week. Bye everyone.